Well, we have some very interesting developments. This is August 4th, about 10:30 Mountain West time. And I wanted to bring your attention. I've been watching this over the last 3 days, and it's very interesting to see. We are at, by the way, up here at the 10 millibars. And that's the very upper part of our atmosphere. And look what's happening here. This has now been pushed further south, and we now have this intermixing at the equator. We have another and yet another one. And when we look down at the 250 millibars, what I have been noticing, and you can go back and look at prior reports, is the southern polar jet stream. It has now become very undulating, broken. The northern is just speaks the story for itself. And again, this intermixing. One of the things I've been watching all day today is the pull on our poles. And as you can see here, this is the current Earth's magnetic pole, and you can see right there for yourself exactly where it's being pulled towards, and you can see that right there. We just had a huge pull, and this graph here gives you the last 24 hours. Again, you can see the correlation looking downward, a pull to the south. I have noticed with my own compass today, taking multiple readings during the day, that we have had a consistent pull to the northwest by approximately 22 degrees. So, and this validates that right here. So what I was reading here in Colorado was in fact taking place. Now, I do believe that our magnetic poles does in fact influence our jet stream. It only makes sense. I'm a proponent of the electrical universe, that electricity is the first and foremost principle, with gravity becoming second place to that. And as you can see here, there are clear indications, again, of the constant drift. And the Earth is constantly being pulled, whether it's by the solar wind or other influences, on the magnetosphere. But we also look at that, how it actually is lifting up. It's just, there you go. It's amazing when you actually watch this in real time, how you can actually see what our planet is actually experiencing. I've left these links before. If you want them, I can leave them again. This is the ACE. And we had a dropout of data, as you can see, but the data is coming back online. By the way, SDO is still out of commission. Don't know what happened on Monday. You all seen the videos that Steve and I have made and what I made as well. Whatever that was, definitely put the hurt on the SDO satellite. Hopefully that'll get back up and operating pretty soon. It was not just 10 minutes ago. As many of you know, I introduced you to livemeteors.com. You can tell that we are picking up. This could be an actual meteor. This is how they do show up. When we start getting these very strong readings, I had someone tell me, well, I didn't know what sporadic E was about. Well, everyone's entitled to their own opinion. However, what I try to do is to go to this map, and this map allows me to see exactly where the sporadic E is at. And this particular transmitter is located right up here in the Del Mar Valley, right outside Washington, D.C., in fact. So it's sending the wave bands with their signal up in this area here. It covers about this part. So you can see we're having sporadic E issues over here in the West Coast. So when we look at these type of readings over here, I can make a correlation between the two and distinguish what is and what is not. Thought I'd introduce another feature. And the reason why I'm doing this is because here in North America, particularly, we have a proliferation as we do in Europe and in most in other countries with lightning detectors. I don't know if you were aware of what took place over here in India, but India has just been absolutely devastated by lightning strikes. And I'm not talking just a couple hundred, not a couple of thousand, we're talking tens of thousands. Again, all signs of something electrical taking place in our atmosphere and into our planet as well. And kind of lastly, thought we'd take a look at what's happening in the area of earthquakes. And again, this area in South America becoming very active. We really need to begin to watch here in the Caribbean. There is some real evidence that there's a couple of the volcanoes there, one in particular that looks like it may begin to blow. And as you can see, the most recent ones all coming out of the Ring of Fire area as well. So just close out. The weather is changing. We're experiencing it here yesterday, hitting 96 degrees, and today in the low 70s, and tomorrow they're saying up in the upper 60s. So the weather is changing, and I think that we have the signs and the indications all around us. It's just that if we can actually pick up the clues and then put the pieces together. All right, keep safe.